What is up, guys? Welcome to the vlog. Today we are starting the video out at a camera shop because unfortunately I have some really bad news. Check this out. Here is my Canon 5D with the 16-35 f2.8, and if you look at it, it is broken. It is really, really broken, and it's not good, and it won't come off the camera body, which is not good. So I broke my like $6,000 camera setup yesterday. I'll flash back to that video right now. What is up, guys? Welcome to the vlog. To start today out, we are going to be putting on the new Legends Media banner. I don't know how I forgot to show you guys this yesterday, but we do have a new style banner. We're bringing back the very first vibe. We have the Legends cut out with the kanji on the bottom. This is a new design. I ahead and took off the Yokohama banner that was up here. Now I'm gonna go and get some product and clean up the windshield, and then we'll be good to lay the Legends Media banner. Well, rip to me, I just broke my camera setup, so that sucks. I had it filming on top of here to get like a time lapse of me, but it fell and the lens is broken, so I don't have too much time today, but fuck. And it won't come off the camera base because this is loose and it doesn't autofocus anymore. It's not good. Either way, not gonna stop today. Need to keep going. We're gonna put this banner on, clean this off, and then lay it down. So as you can see, we were installing the new Legends Media banner right here yesterday, and I had the camera set up and it fell face down, which is weird, and it like broke the lens. Just a bad time. I'm taking it to George's camera shop, so hopefully he can just fix the lens and I don't have to actually buy another one because it's gonna hurt. So hopefully that can get fixed, and today hopefully we'll have time to install one of the mods on the Type R.
I've got a sad situation here.
Me in a camera shop is 100% a bad idea because I always want to buy everything, but we have some goodish news, I guess. So they can't do the repairs directly in this store, but they are going to send it off to get me an estimate. He does think it can be repaired. I don't have to buy a whole new setup. It'd be about 7 to 10 business days until I hear back on a quote, and then 6 to 8 weeks for repairs, which is like I have my camera for like 3 months. Either way, we're gonna make it work. Good thing I have the A7S II as my backup. Now that we got that out of the way, let's head to the shop and do some mods. All right, finally made it back to the shop. For today, we are installing this Legends Media toe strap. These will be available on the site this Sunday at 12. So from everything that I've seen on the Type R, everyone mounts their toe straps somewhere in this area right here and kind of just cuts out a few pieces of the mesh. So I'm gonna go ahead and take off the front bumper and inspect on where everybody's mounting these because I can't find the exact spot online. I'm pretty positive it's around the crash beam or maybe where the bracket for the front mount is. I don't really know yet. Once I get this bumper off, I can tell better. Bumper's off. I found where I'm gonna mount the toe strap at. So this is the safety crash beam. There's little holes right here. I'm actually just gonna mount the toe strap right here using the supplied hardware. The only thing that my hardware doesn't come with is washers. So I went and just found some spare washers that I had laying around, and I'm gonna use one on the front and one on the back. I'll show you guys whenever I get done screwing it in right here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and cut the mesh where that little circle opening is so that this can hang out and it's gonna look really good. So it'll actually be a functioning toe strap for on the track and stuff like that, which is a plus. Go ahead and get started. So this is where it will be mounted.
Ready?
Yep, good luck. That's all you need, dude. That's way too tight already.
Sweet. So toast wrap is now on. Now I have to mock up the front bumper and cut out the mesh pieces where I want this to actually hang out from. Not everybody needs to mount their toast wrap where I'm mounting mine. So on the Subaru, I'll overlay a picture here where I have mine mounted. And that was a super easy install as well. Probably a lot easier than what this is, but this is fully functional. But I mean, a lot of people that do it. So time to figure out where I want to cut the mesh. Is pushed and clipped back in, just not the small little tiny clips. Now it's time for me to cut out this mesh right here. Simple and very easy mod to do. It's complete. I actually like it in this location, so I wasn't curious about if I was gonna like it or not, but I do. I actually could have taken more of this mesh off, but I do know that like Evasive Motorsports is coming out with a solution for this entire mesh piece. So I didn't want to cut too much and then risk them coming out with this piece soon to actually like have a place to slip toast wrap out of. So I left it like this for now, and I'm gonna wait for this whole piece to come out from like Evasive or a Japanese part supplier or something like that. That's actually gonna make it easy to route that out of the bumper. So yeah, very successful. I like it a lot. I do have a question for you guys. If you remember a few videos back, I do have all of these parts still for the gearbox. We have the bushing, the short shifter adapter, as well as the shifter cable adapter. My question to you guys is, would you rather see me install each part individually so I can give you an in-depth step-by-step look at how to install these parts, or should I go ahead and do them all in one day and give you a general overview of how I'm doing these parts? Because it's either gonna go one or the other. I can either do a detailed install of, say, like one day we'll do a detailed install of the short shifter adapter, and then the next day we'll do the bushing, or I could just do a general overview of, hey, I'm doing all of these parts today, I'll walk you through as much as I can, and then we'll just give like a really badass gearbox review video after that. So let me know in the comments down below what you guys think about that. Okay guys, finally made it back home.
I came to one of my favorite spots to hang out, and I'm actually gonna do a little bit of shooting. My car is filthy right now. Tried to go to one of those self car wash things and it was absolutely packed, so hopefully it doesn't look too bad in pictures, but it is very, very dirty.
I haven't done any pictures for the accessories, so like the JIT tags, the license plate frames, the stickers, so I'll do a little edit cool thing of all like the JIT tags and stuff that I have with it. Okay guys, so that is gonna be it for today's video. I know the install was a pretty short one, but it's a really cool and fun mod to do depending on where you put it. I hope you guys really like the Legends Media toe straps. I've been looking for those forever and we finally found them. So like I said, they will be up on the Legends Media site this Sunday, June 10th at 12 p.m. Pacific time. So be sure to grab those because we have all of our shirts, we have the JIT tags, stickers, license plate frames, we have all of that stuff dropping, and it's gonna be a really cool and really fun drop. So be sure to set your alarms and don't miss out on that one. And also, I did want to tell you guys that Saturday, June 9th, I will be at Angel Stadium for the autocross event from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. So if you're interested in that, want to come see me do some autocross, if you're going to be at the event, let me know, because that'd be really fun. I've like become obsessed with autocross, so I will be with the Type R doing some autocross this Saturday. It'll be a lot of fun. I'll put the link to the autocross site down below in case you're ever interested, because they do have this all the time in Anaheim at Angel Stadium. So with all of that being said, I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.